Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Threads. I hope you're all doing well. Just in case you're new here, please consider subscribing to our channel and also hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. So yes, in today's video, I'm going to show how to crochet this beautiful sleeve to any outfit you want. Crocheted sleeves just enhances the look of that garment, so that's why I tried doing this on one of my short kurtis which I wear on a regular basis. So without any delay, let's get started. I'm using needle number 7 along with Kamal Kadai thread. If you want to make this in cotton thread, you can use cotton ball as well. So first of all, we'll start with a slip knot like this, and we'll start working chains. I am not going to count the chains. We are just going to stick with the measurement that I have already made. You will just have to work chains for this length. So this will be your sleeve round. So after the slip knot, I'm just continuing with chains. So this is how you will continue. As and how you proceed, you can just measure it to see if you have reached the required length. To make it easier, you can actually cut do a paper cutting of a sleeve beforehand so that we know we are going in the right way. Now I have this sleeve that I did not attach for one of my dresses, so this is what I am using as a reference, but I didn't want the length to be so long. So according to this, I have made the sleeve because I'm going to attach it on this fabric itself. So to get an idea of how we are proceeding, it is better to have a paper cutting. So now I'll just continue making chains until I reach the required sleeve round. I finished making the chains to the same length here. Now I'm going to make 3 extra chains and start working 1 double crochet in each chain stitch. This is for this border here. I just wanted this border line to be thick, so that is why I'm doing this. So it's very simple, just keep doing 1 double crochet in each chain stitch until you reach the end. So this is how you will continue till you reach the end. I finished working double crochets in each of the chain stitches here. So this is how it is looking. Now I'm going to chain 4 and turn the work. Here we will skip one stitch, and in every alternate double crochet we will do a double crochet. So after the double crochet stitch, I'm going to work 1 chain. So this is how this step will continue. So this is the next stitch I'm going to skip, and 1 double crochet in here, and followed by a chain.
So we'll ideally have to repeat this step two more times. So 1, 2, and 3. After 3 times, we will start reducing so that we can we get this kind of shape. So you just continue working till the end and repeat the same step 2 more times. I have finished working 3 times the same thing, 1 double crochet, 1 chain and the next double crochet in the alternate stitch. But for this step I have worked in the single chain gap. So this is how it is looking at this stage. Now from now on we will start reducing the stitches, that is to get this shape. So I'll start with one chain and one single crochet in the one chain gap, and then one chain, second single crochet in the second chain gap, and we'll do this 4 times. After 4 single crochet stitches, I'm going to do 2 chains and start working double crochets like we did in the previous row. After double crochet, I've made 1 chain and the next double crochet again goes into this space here below the 1 chain gap. So this is how this step will continue. So I've almost reached the end. I just have to work one more stitch. So I've done chain 1 and the last double crochet in here. This is the 5th stitch from the left side. And then chain 2, work 1 single crochet, chain 1, 1 single crochet, chain 1, 1 single crochet, again chain 1 and 1 single crochet. So we have 4 stitches here and 4 stitches on the other side. So now we'll have to follow the same thing, but every time we turn our work and proceed to the next step, we'll be adding plus 4 single crochets here. So in this step, 4 plus 4, we are going to work 8 single crochets before we start working the double crochet stitches. And this is how you'll have to continue. So I'm going to chain 1. And first single crochet here in the 1 chain gap. And then chain 1. Second single crochet. Chain 1. Third stitch. Chain 1. Fourth one, again chain 1, just continue until you reach 8 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, chain 1, this is my last single crochet here, and then I'm going to chain 2 and continue with double crochet stitches. So this is how you will have to continue until the desired length of the sleeve you want to make. So in total, I think I'll have to work 6 more times to reach this length. I finished all the steps and just left with one last one, which is this part, and here I've done a treble so that, you know, for sewing it will be easy. So just trying to match both, and you can see they're both even and we're just left with this step. Now I'm going to turn the work, start off with one chain and one single crochet. Same one chain and one single crochet. So we'll repeat the same thing until we reach this point. So this is where I have reached, and now at this point we'll just do two more single crochets instead of four like in the previous rows. So one single crochet and one chain, and one more single crochet. Now I'll do two chains and start making the treble stitches in this chain gap, and one chain, one treble. So the same way you will have to continue this side, and you'll have to stop before two stitches and just work single crochets in these two, and then keep working single crochet and one chain stitch until you reach this point, and then your sleeve will be ready. So I've got it attached to this top of mine. I didn't do it myself. I took a tailor's help to do this, and this is how it looks. This is exactly how I wanted it to be, more like a cap sleeve, and I really love the way it looks. This is the other side. So you can follow the same process to work your sleeve in any length. I wanted it to be a cap sleeve, so that is why I worked only this length. So you can try this out for your silk blouses as well. It's going to look just amazing. Now inside I have just used the same fabric. Actually this was a sleeveless top which came along with the sleeves inside. So I've used the same fabric inside because I felt the thread didn't match the color of the top exactly. So I thought of keeping the fabric inside, which is optional. If you want, you can simply stitch this crocheted sleeves and that will look gorgeous too. So I hope you guys like this video. If you have any requests, please do leave them in the comment section below. In case you have any doubts, mention them as well. And please consider joining our channel and being a member. To do that, you'll have to click on the join button and pay the minimal fees that is required, and you will get access to special videos, special live streams, and much more, special discount coupons from Naughty Threads. So please consider that. And yeah, I guess that's about it for today. Share our videos with your friends, subscribe to our channel, and please subscribe to our other channel, Naughty Vlogs, as well. I'll see you soon with my next video. Until then, take care guys. Bye bye.